surviving work for free as the state of Belarus. Definitely an interesting starting location, and hopefully today we are going to defeat Russia and make our country a democratic nation again, or something like that. Not entirely sure though, we immediately have a negative army, and I hope you are going to enjoy today's video. We've immediately joined a team with Russia and are attacking Ukraine, and we took off the territory. Leave our team with Russia and attack them, and no way, can we actually take them? Please, take them, take them, take them, take them, take them. It would make things so much easier. No, we're out of money. I thought we could actually take them. Pain. Let's try that one again. The good thing is that we aren't that far away from the Russian capital. And if we take them, we instantly gain a bunch of territory. We took Lithuania. And I really enjoy that starting location. We are getting attacked by Ukraine. No Ukraine, no Ukraine, no Ukraine. And we died again. Try number three. Okay, try number three. Hopefully, and we again have a negative army. Can we attack anyone? I don't think so. We have a positive army and might be able to attack Ukraine. Not entirely sure though, we took them. If we need a negative army in Russia, and we have got that, and hopefully we can now take them. Also attack Lithuania, they have negative army, we took them, and we have a positive army in Russia again. And we got puppeted by Russia. Okay, hopefully they aren't going to instantly take territory. We are attacking both Poland and Lithuania, and we gain territory of them, and attack Russia, and they have a negative army. They have a negative army, peace out, peace out, peace out. Or maybe take them. Can we actually take them? We are so close to Moscow. No, 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 no. Estonia, Estonia, no, no. Okay, we almost died there and I think we can take Russia. We took all of Russia. Okay. However, we still have a very weak capital on the border to Estonia. We need a positive army and a negative army in Estonia. If they attack, we are pretty much dead. We both have a positive army. Are you kidding me? We have annexed, I think, either Romania or Bulgaria. And we have a negative army and a neutral one in Estonia. Estonia, don't attack us. And they have a negative army. We need to take them now. Take them, take them, take them, take them, take them, take them, take them. Okay. Okay, we now have a massive amount of territory and I think we are fairly safe. We even took North Korea. Okay. We need to have a look at Mongolia and Kazakhstan. And we have a pretty big Germany. Germany might be doing the impossible and not die unless we take them. Of course we can take them. They are Germany in ages of conflict and they can never survive. Negative army in Kazakhstan and now they have a positive one. Are you kidding me? And they have a negative army again and we took them. We also have a negative army though, I think. Is that the UK or that's actually Argentina who somehow took them biting the Falkland Islands or something? Maybe they have puppeted them. That would make sense and we are getting attacked by Norway and our capital isn't insanely safe. We have any other capital outside of Europe? Not so far, sadly. So that might become a problem down the line. Negative army. And we have a pretty massive Myanmar pushing to Turkey and hopefully we might be able to puppet them. Guys, no, no, no. Okay. They attack. Also attack Uzbekistan. Just take the capital, thank you. But Turkey are still surviving and we have a negative army again. Argentina are still pushing. You've got to be kidding me. Pushing to Algeria. Pushing to Algeria. And maybe finally gain some territory somewhere. We've puppeted them. Very important. And Brazil took Argentina. Thank you very much, Brazil. And we need to push into China. If we could puppet them, that would be pretty insane. We should be first place. We are, but not by a massive margin. As the USA took Canada. Positive army. And time to push into Turkey. Can we gain some territory off them? We have puppeted them. Very important. And we are also kind of annexing Algeria now. Montenegro, we took them. How many people did we take so far? 11 different people. Nice. That's very important to gain even more. We are still fighting China and can't really take territory of them. However, they've also puppeted Japan and it would be nice if we could puppet Japan off them and they have already annexed them. Annoying. Do we have any territory in the Americas? I don't think so. But what should we do now? Iran. Take and hopefully puppet them. We've puppeted them. Very nice. If we could puppet China somehow or... Okay, I'm going to leave my old team and attack Norway and hopefully instantly puppet them. Guys, please puppet Norway. Thank you very much. We also need to attack Greece very soon to get another puppet. And they already have a negative army. They're kind of falling and we've puppeted them as well. Afghanistan is probably the next country to attack, but they have a positive army. Now we both have a negative one, both a neutral one. And we can finally push into them. They have a neutral army and they're pushing again. China is also pushing with a neutral army and negative army in China. We are gaining a bunch of territory. And we've puppeted them. That's kind of insane. Puppets are pretty insane today, as you can see. Okay, okay, Brazil took Spain. How many people are alive? The main countries are really weird, the United States and Brazil. That's the most important stuff. Leave our team with Chad and hopefully puppet them instead. Guys, puppet them. We've puppeted them, very important. And a bunch of people are giving us money. I think I might actually fight both the US and Brazil to death. Although Brazil stares a bunch of money, but we should have more puppets than they have. Okay, we are fighting them to death. Hopefully we have a decently safe capital and... Okay, now they're actually pushing. Guys, we need to... We can't get a bunch of bad luck. Push them back. They might actually take Norway. Okay, they took Norway. Are we actually losing a money game for once? China's also falling. They had a negative army. And we have a pretty massive Australia. Our money situation isn't looking great. But we could still push into India. And can we take or at least puppet India? Can't even puppet India. China's still fighting Australia and they are pushing into Myanmar. Oh, okay, we aren't looking great. By the way, leave a like if you've enjoyed the video so far. Doing that really supports the video and you can help it in the algorithm and also subscribe to your channel as that way you won't miss any further uploads. I'm still hoping I can win the money game. We only have 50k left though and in the US has the 20k. Brazil more than 100k. Okay, I need to deal out with them. But I think I'm actually, we are already kind of dead. We can't really do much. We have so much in Brazil unless we can take like half of the rest of the map and push into Australia. They aren't in a bigger team though and Brazil is still fighting us. Mexico also in the massive team over here. That doesn't look good for us. Now even the DR Congo is pushing. Can we even annex our own puppets? DR Congo negative army, but we can't really push them, although we have a positive army again. And if we could puppet them, that'd be pretty insane, but we are losing even more territory. No, guys, please, no. We again have a negative army. And how much money does Brazil have? They still have more than 100k. I don't know how we can win this. But they still don't have the most territory though. And Myanmar, we took all of China. Should we also push into Myanmar? I am still not sure. Okay, there is pushing into Myanmar. Not really able to do much else. We have also annexed Iran, but we are now getting pushed by like everybody. We are on a team of Australia though, but I'm pretty sure now we are, yeah, I'm fighting Brazil to the death. There's no way we are going to win. Unless, how much money does Australia have? They have only 6k. Okay, we are pretty much dead. Yeah, Congo might be a bit of a wildcard though, and they have 40k. If they attack Brazil, that might be a positive thing. Although, now all are losing money. We have 45k, and our cars are actually really similar to the USA. And we are pushing into the USA in Alaska. Can we actually take territory of them? That we need a bunch of more luck. I don't think we're going to get that. They still have 23k. How much do we have? We have 44k. And Brazil's, why is Brazil out of money? Who did they give their money to? How? Why are we winning? Are we actually winning now? I'm not sure what's happening. How are we winning? We have the most gold on the entire map, but why do we have that? I don't understand anything, but now we have less than USA, and I think we have to peace out with everyone now. Peace out, chill for a bit, and we aren't teaming, I don't know what to do. We only have 5k left now. Are we actually giving off our money to Australia or something? No, we aren't. We still have Indonesia surviving somehow, 6k in the DR Congo, and the same in the USA, and I think that's not actually enough to win. Now they're even pushing. No, I think they are, yeah, they have more money than we have, or maybe Australia's there's money on their own. Okay, I think I have to fight to the death. I'm still not entirely sure who is going to win. Stuff is actually pretty insanely close. And fight them to the death. You can see the money situation. I think we have a bit more, but we also have Australia and they only have 4k. We have almost the same amount of money. And Australia is kind of gaining money, or are they? I don't know if they're gaining. Congo might be losing, and in comparison, both we and Australia are now gaining. And I think we might actually be able to win this. No way. It's so insanely close. You can see it in the money department. Australia is now almost has more than we have. USA and DR Congo now under 2k both. We are also almost under 2k. Australia actually has the most of all people. Hopefully they won't actually annex us because of that. And we are almost out of money. Okay. Only Australia has any money left and we can't even push anyone. Okay. Because we have no money left. We are fighting them again. again. Australia is taking a bunch of territory though. We are regaining money, but we've puppeted USA. And Australia has more territory, or not more territory, but more money than we have. And we're actually giving them money. No, don't tell me they're going to annex us and not the other way around. How much area do they have? They're far less than we have. I have no idea what's going to happen now. We took more territory of the USA. Why are we giving money to Australia? Why? Integration? They aren't a puppet master. We took 22 different people though. And now we are fighting Australia. How much money do they have? Are you kidding me? No! Yeah, we have lost. Because they actually have more money than we have and I don't even have to fight. Like, I can just go and die. Because Australia actually won the game. They were pretty smart and played the money game. And they did a uni reverse on all of Belarus and all of the rest of the world. I hope you enjoyed this video. In the end, we took 77k territory. And that might be the most I've ever lost with. Leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. And here you can find a different one. They have tried to survive as the state of Hawaii and tried to conquer the USA. In the description you can find my Discord server and have free to join it. But that's everything from me for today. And therefore I'm going to say, bye.